And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later over there for some Gruul Frenzy action for our first deck of the day. Hey Narinen, welcome back. Thanks for that resub. I really do appreciate that. So the point of Gruul Frenzy here, this is a deck that I played some before War of the Spark came out. Haven't played it since. But I wanted to revisit it. You know, we've been playing a lot of War of the Spark stuff, and I wanted to kind of go through back some previous decks that we have played and see if we can update them and see how they work out. And this is one of the first ones. So basically, the point of this deck is to get a whole lot of lands in play for this experimental frenzy, like with experimental frenzy here. So we know how good this card is, like mostly in mono red, right? Like people just play this at the top end of mono red. But what people don't really do too much is just use this in a mid-range deck to just be able to get lots of land drops. Like you still only get one land drop a turn, of course, with Experimental Frenzy. But if we join it with Wayward Swordtooths, where you can play multiple lands a turn, suddenly you can start casting spells until you use both of your land drops. And so like two land drops. Then if you find another Swordtooth off the top that you get to play, suddenly you get three land drops a turn if you have two Swordtooths in play, and so on. And so, you know, like we're just trying to like basically rifle through our deck, get a whole lot of lands in play, and then with a whole lot of lands, we can do a couple of things. We can kick Fight with Fires to finish people off. We have these flyers that finish games off in the air, especially Skargon Hellkite when you have a lot of mana. You know, activating Skargon Hellkite a bunch can do a lot of damage. Before I played Treasure Map in the deck, and I'm basically taking out Treasure Map and replacing Treasure Map with Chandra, you know, from new card from this set, that I think could work really well in this deck, because gives us like our other card advantage card besides Frenzy. Like if we haven't drawn a Frenzy, you know, like the Chandras can get us like an extra card every turn. But then these two play pretty well together, right? Like if we do hit too many lands for us to play, you know, we can always tick up the Chandra to basically clear off the top card to see if we can continue going with Frenzy there. So that'll be interesting to try out. We also got some Living Twisters in the sideboard for the aggro matchups. This could work kind of well with this also, of like, I don't know, if we have like a lot of lands, we would have like extra ammunition to return lands back to our hand to be able to discard them. Or even just like when we have our Frenzy in play, we can't play the cards in our hand, right? So if we draw extra lands like from like different turns with Frenzy, and we just have lands in our hand that we can't play because Frenzy's in play, we can discard those lands, those extra cards in hand with Living Twister. So that could be a pretty interesting sideboard card there. But that's our deck. Let's give it a try and see how it goes. All right, so today I'm just feeling like doing our traditional constructed queues today. Especially with like just trying this deck out for the very first time in this format. Thank you so much, Drake, for that information there. All right, let's keep it. Oh man, Kathios, I'm sorry. Yeah, I have, check my deck list page there. I put three decks for Singleton up there. Three mid-range decks. Well, like one control deck and two mid-range decks for Singleton up there. So you can take a look at those. Maybe those will help you out. Write this down real quick. All right. I'll lead with Rekindling Phoenix here. You know, if I play Chandra and tick up, there's nothing, of course, for Chandra to you know, we can't play like another land, but like next turn I could play Chandra, tick up, try to hit a land drop if we don't draw a land here. Hey, Irvin, thank you so much for that Twitch Prime sub. I really do appreciate that. Welcome to the channel. Yeah, really appreciate that support. Thank you very much. Oh. Domri has the plus one plus zero part also. Well, could have got another point in there.
Let's see some panic in the streets. What's that? Something smells rotten. Wait, that might be me.
Yep, missed out on that one damage there. Sure did. Hey, Lex Bros. Yeah, we missed one damage. Yep, there's that one cheer for the one damage we missed. Swordtooth is kind of sweet with Domri because it's such a big body. Also, can fight basically anything. I think Singleton, I mean, I'm not exactly sure, but I believe Singleton runs out on Thursday. I think that's kind of like whenever. I think it's like Thursday to Thursday. No, don't get these phoenixes back, no. Ugh.
Any skirmish you can walk away from, right?
Well, the whole goal of our deck, of course, is to get a lot of lands into play. We are not doing a very good job of that, admittedly. If these Chandras were treasure maps, it would help out a little bit more, to be honest. That's a small sample here.
Together, we'll create great things, you and I.
Oh, it goes away on Friday. Okay. I honestly haven't played any of the Singleton yet. I don't think I'll be able to tomorrow. So I'll have like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday morning to get 15 wins. So you could play cards that are like better against red removal, like Ripjaw Raptor, Living Twister are like decent against red removal, right? Like they can't just like shock and coil these things. I definitely want this extra coil. However, they can't just fly over those pretty easily. I don't know if, like, Rekindling Phoenix is really that great here because of how weak it is to Lava Coil and how they're just going to have... They have just a ton of Lava Coils in their deck. Hey, Gustavo, doing good. I think I kind of just want to try this again, though. Obviously, we didn't do well that game, but I'm going to give this another try. I could, like, move away from Chandra's for those, like, Living Twisters and everything. Living Twister and Ripjaw Raptor.
Thank you.
All the other events have gone away in the like early afternoon, Eastern time, like in the 1, 2, 3 o'clock range, somewhere around there. So if you're saying it ends on Friday, I'm kind of guessing there'll probably be like same kind of time there. That's the easiest block I've ever made. Like, why not just keep the Arclight Phoenix back to block so I can't just attack with it? I did not Braxis. So we want to draw Frenzy. That's the card we want to draw here. Of course, I mean, our deck's named Frenzy, so that's probably pretty obvious. That's our deck name, but that's the card that we want to draw. Frenzy. All right, I need to take this. All right, sorry about that. That was the plumber scheduling for tomorrow. They're going to be over because I have for my water pipe that's leaking right now. They're going to be over right away first thing in the morning tomorrow, so that's good. I can relive. He's ordering Chipotle. They're going to be calling me 7:30 in the morning, they said, so I'm going to have to get to bed a little early tonight. Ooh, ditching a Finale of Promise. What am I drawing, Lava Coils or... That's it. Three cards in hand. Still want to mind. Basically, any of our cards in our deck, like Chandra, wouldn't be so bad. Obviously, Hellkite, Skargon Hellkite would be nice. Lava Coil, Experimental Frenzy. Fight with Fire, we would be one mana off of kicking Fight with Fire. Hey, Zephyrs. So Finale of Promising, a Finale of Promise. Actually, I've not seen anybody do that before. And I guess it didn't really work. Hey, Hellkite. Yes, they could have just done like Charter Course instead. But they did it for three, so it's like they were trying to do the other Finale of Promise for one, but there's not other cards for one in the graveyard. I'm not using Field of Ruin because there's not really, one, there's not really any reason for me to use Field of Ruin, but then a good reason to save Field of Ruin is if we would draw Experimental Frenzy and then we would get stuck and we'd want to shuffle the top card of our library. That's the reason to save the Field of Ruin in case that happens. Alright, we should be able to just have lethal next turn. As long as the Hellkite gets to stay alive. You know, we're just keeping up like our 4 damage here, where if we need to, we can hit the Crackling Drake, but no, looks like they... So they could kill the Paradise Druid here. Come on. Activate this, thank you. Samuel, with that support there, thank you so much. I really do appreciate that. Welcome to the channel. Hope you're having a good Monday. All right, so maybe I should play some Shivan Fires. So maybe I should have played these, like they kill the Goblin Electromancer or they can kill the Crackling Drakes later. I'm going to take out a couple Chandras. We'll still have the one Chandra in there. Yeah, good job, Hellkite. Oh, you're welcome, Samuel. Glad you're liking all the decks. Love it. We got Frenzy. Yeah. They're going to kill my Paradise Druid, though, and I won't be able to play my Frenzy, and I'm going to be sad. Ooh, Landwerf. Best draw possible. So the big question is if we play Rekindling Phoenix first before we play Frenzy. And probably, but we'll see. Kind of the deck that's like, it's really not that bad to get Frenzy out as fast as possible sometimes. But yeah, especially with drawing the Lava Coil, I think I'm most likely going to be just playing Phoenix next turn and try to be able to go like Coil plus Frenzy. Six mana a future turn. That would... require more mana sources. But I want to be able to cast this Coil, so maybe next turn Coil plus Druid. We'll kind of see. Mm-hmm. Get out of here. Lindsay. And here we go. All right. Getting it started. You know, getting two cards a turn, but just keep on hitting these land drops. Eventually we'll find Sawtooth and get more land drops and everything like that. Phoenix. All right, no more Phoenixes for this turn. This is just Duncan Dinos with Druid? I haven't heard that, but that's pretty good. Duncan Dinos with Druid. Is that the tagline to our deck here? Oh, they have their two Phoenixes. Are they not getting their Phoenixes back? Doesn't seem like it. No Phoenixes for them. So I can blow up Frenzy and cast Fight with Fire on this thing and have lethal. Or I can just kick a Shiv and Fire. Attack. Frenzy's great. Wanna know? Duncan comes from Frenzy's flavor text? Really? Okay. Duncan Dinos. Turns out coffee is the weird aunt of invention. I had never read that flavor text before. Well, we got our combo, Sawtooth Frenzy, so went ahead and kept it. Having a lot of lands is not a bad thing with Frenzy. We'll see if we're too slow for mono red, though. Of course, I can have turn 4 Hellkite instead of Frenzy. Hellkite seems pretty okay in this matchup. Being a 5/5. Rude. Well, Sawtooth kind of did his job. Got me an extra land drop and gained 5 life. And took 2 cards. 2-for-1 to the opponent there. This art's kind of weird. Stop. Alright, can we hold all of this stuff back? Unlikely. But we'll see. Phoenix is not the best here. It doesn't block like Chain Whirler particularly well or anything. I'm just going to trade it off for these two creatures. I don't think that taking this, going to seven, and then trying to block the next turn is really worth it, honestly, because that's a lot of damage coming in. So we'll just trade it for Firebrand and Lava Runner. Nice. All right, so now do I Frenzy or Chandra? I think we Chandra first. Hope to hit the land drop here.
I know. What's that smell?
That's unfortunate.
Oh, it's you burning.
Unfortunate timing on Hellkite. No, attack Chandra. Don't attack me. Don't kill me.
This is just gonna be bad for you.
All right, we're gonna rifle through our deck pretty fast here. Just take the trade before there's like a Chain Whirler or something. Wouldn't mind a Sword Tooth.
Let's light it up.
Might as well. All right, got another card deeper. Now we'll draw this land. Sword Tooth. More lands. Alright, so next turn I can do seven. Yeah, should be able to kill my opponent here.
Sit back and watch it burn.
Kick a fight with fire. 10 upstairs. All right. So mono red, I want this extra coil, these Shivan Fires. And then we got all these Brontodons, Ripjaw, Living Twisters. All those can come on in. Chandra, Phoenix. Do I take out Swordtooth? Let me take out Domri. Let me take out Fight with Fires. Don't think I should probably shouldn't just take out Sword Tooth. I guess like Paradise Druid is not like so great here. It's just all threes though. Yeah, Swordtooth is kind of our late game card, which maybe we don't really want the late game card against mono red. All right, so that's what my deck looks like. With taking Sword 2 out, let's try this. Yeah, I don't really like for a four, like the Phoenix for 4 mana, I don't really like it too much. I like how, like, basically kind of replacing Phoenix with like Living Twisters, Brontodons, and Ripjaw Raptors, because, you know, Phoenix will, you know, besides just, you know, only trading one for one for with Coil, it also, like, you know, any like 3 damage burn spell, you know, kills it, and then Chain Whirler or Firebrand can like finish it off very easily there, or even just like Chain Whirler in general. It just matches up so bad against Chain Whirler. Like, it can't block Chain Whirler very efficiently. Just matches up really bad there. No, I never play 62-63. It's not something you really want to be doing. What? Taking out the cards you won with, yeah, true. Please don't have Chain Whirler. Don't do it. No. Bleh. Hey Zerf. Going good. We need the lands. Hey Holes, good afternoon. I'm really, really thinking about just like killing the Steamkin here by ditching the land, killing the Steamkin. No, I'm not going to. Definitely that's what I was just considering. Bribbleck, you may be behind. We got world twice. Definitely losing this game. Like, I'm not gonna be able to beat those things out there. Looks like they just have a burn spell here. Well, if I draw Fiery Cannonade, I guess they had to use that mana. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, even if they have nothing, that's 7 coming in. They just have lethal. If you just attack with everything and just wizards lightning me, I'd be at six. Those things are all 3/3s. What are you doing? Let's get more of these. Let's get less of these. Gosh, these Paradise Druids are just so bad. If they have Chain Whirler like that. Alright, let's just play mono threes. Let's just try playing the Swordtooth again. We saw how much our opponent liked killing Swordtooth with all those burn spells the first game. Denriel, that's not really mono red, that's magic. You can bad pilot or misplay any deck in Magic and still win. It's not just a mono red thing. All right, well, we got Brontodons here. Draw some lands. It's not a land. Need to draw land still. Still not a land. They didn't play a third land. Now they did. Hey, JMS. Land drop. Ugh. What card that is in standard right now gives the biggest no to mono red right now? What is the card somebody should look at if they are on mono red tilt? Oh, wait. I wanted to take 4 damage. That's unfortunate. Seriously? Yeah, a lot of people are saying some good ones there. Othakaya, Revitalize, like, the problem is, you know, like, Frenzy can still, like, beat basically every single card that everybody says there. Knight of Autumn, so Knight of Autumn's a good one, because that can kill Frenzy and gain 4 life. I mean, I think Lyra Dawnbringer is kind of better than all of those cards. Against Mono Red, it's probably Lyra Dawnbringer. Other cards people are saying are Absorb, Moment of Craving, Bell Hunt, Revitalize, Othakaya, Thorn Lieutenant. God. We'll just get a land. Play this Llanowar Elf. Blah. We kept a 3-lander. drawn 6 cards. So it's turn 7. Yep. No surprise there. No idea why our opponent doesn't attack with Chain Whirler, but... How do you use Experimental Frenzy? You just play it, and then you play the cards off... You play the cards from the top of your library. So that's all we want to do, is be able to play it, but it's just way too late now. Yeah, we need this, like, turn, like, 5, not turn 8. I mean, it's about to be turn 9. Finally. Yeah, I think our opponent thinks that these Sawtooths can block. I should already be dead, but we're gonna be dead here. It just takes a little bit longer. I mean, I don't have life gain in here, so. Bleh. Kept a 3-lander, just wanted to draw 1 land in the first 5 turns. And we couldn't do it. Had to wait till 9 turns to draw land. Yep, Chain Whirler is a great card. Alright, new game. Espa. Huh. Just Oath of Kaya shoot me for 3? Oh no, wrong button. This isn't working. There we go. All right, so 2 of our 3 lava coils against, you know, having 2 of our 3 lava coils against the control deck, not ideal, but it's not like, even though we don't have anything, really, we're not out of this. You know, Frenzy can just win games.
Listen up, and I'll teach you what to do. We are the future.
Boom.
Now, don't be difficult.
Okay. Sorry, taking care of some business. There. How do you feel about Druid of the Cowl? Yeah, I mean, Druid of the Cowl is obviously a lot better against mono red than Paradise Druid is. The thing is Paradise Druid does get to add that red mana. It's definitely possible that just Incubation Druid... I mean, Incubation Druid's better against mono red, but Paradise Druid's a lot better against Teferi. But it could just be playing like a bunch of Incubation Druids instead of a bunch of Paradise Druids. If you face a lot of mono red, I would make that change. I would play Incubation instead of Paradise. I think adding that extra red mana though is pretty important though, with all these Rekindling Phoenixes and yeah, with like the Rekindling Phoenixes and Chandras and stuff like that. Like the adding the two red, where like Druid of the Cowl doesn't add red.
Are you certain of your decision?
So we're at 4, 6, 9. So we're at 9 permanents currently. So Swordtooth needs another permanent. And there's a permanent right there.
What's that smell? Oh, it's you burning.
Come on, attack. There you go. Yeah, Paradise Druid is better against like the control decks, better against Little Teferi.
I am the master here.
And you know, can attack. Basically, it can just attack right away. Where, Incubation Druid cannot.
Sit back and watch it burn.
Well, it was really good to draw that Chandra. Unfortunately, the Chandra did find the Swordtooth, I guess, but I didn't find too much sense then. Fight with fire would be a good one. So like, I could just -7 the Chandra, kill the Liliana, and get 7 cards. I should probably do that. It's probably too greedy not to.
Because,
you know, if I don't do that, and they just, you know, find a Teferi to tuck it, or a Vrass's Contempt, or anything like that. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have 10 mana. So this costs 2. So I have, I guess I can use the Llanowar off 2. So that's 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I can't get all three of these. One mana short from getting Domri, Swordtooth, and Hellkite. I think I just want. I guess Domri and Hellkite.
Did you just call me Scrolly? Oh, you'll pay for that. There'll be nothing but dust when I'm done. I will have to form a new plan.
Yeah, still one short even with Domri adding mana. I guess I could have added mana and played the Paradise Druid, but I just fought that 2-2, got that out of there. Yeah, I didn't do the haste with the Hellkite because, like, look at all this mana here. If I just draw a brick, you know, if I draw a land here, I get to actually, like, do a lot of damage with, like, this Hellkite activation, and I can kind of do that a couple of times. And, like, this Hellkite activation would be pretty good at picking off other Planeswalkers and stuff.
I was raised by wolves, though they might have also just been big dogs.
All they're gonna have to draw Kaya's wrath.
Let's slow this down. Keep up the
right,
pace.
Like... Alright, good job, Chandra. Way to ultimate. So let's get other Chandra. And if I bring in other Chandra, if we cut the lava coils, like what else do I want to bring in? Do I want to bring in Fight with Fires? I guess Brontodons. I don't think I need four Fight with Fires. Is this card better than Brontodon? Nah, probably not. In that. Oh gosh. This is just the same thing but worse. But it is six. I'm not going to go to five. Do I think that this deck can be played on the ladder? Yeah, I mean, yes. Like, there's... Like, yeah, like, so we were, you know, like we've been playing against same decks you'll see on the ladder here, you know, Esper Control, Mono Red, and everything. I, you know, it's, this is my first time trying it out in this format, so it's not perfectly tuned or anything, you know, but, I've enjoyed playing it so far. It's felt pretty good. I don't really know why I wouldn't be able to be played in on the ladder matches also. Haste. So if they're going to kill the Hellkite, I'd prefer that they would use a Mortify to kill Hellkite, where hopefully I could have, like, the Frenzy stick around.
My army will be putrid, but effective.
Liliana really strong.
That's no way to treat a lady. They were a lousy servant anyway.
Hey, Delotrius.
Rise.
Oh no. Okay, coming in at the wrong time.
Smelly.
Need lands. That's not a land. I need some lands. Land drops. No land drops. That's why Liliana is so good. Like, it's not even worthwhile to attack Liliana because they just get to chump block and draw a card. Like, that's not even a good trade for me, them chump blocking, draw a card. Ugh. So I need the lands before.
Waste not what I've learned much from your death.
Yeah, the mana elves, not what we need there. Oh no. All right, what's this Liliana at? Six. Maybe they can't kill another Hellkite.
So
but yeah, the Brontodont gets to blow up the binding, of course. But please don't kill this Hellkite. Let the Hellkite kill Liliana, please. If they binding Hellkite, it'll be kind of interesting to see if I need to like blow up the binding on the Hellkite to kill the Liliana or blow up the one on the Frenzy. Bleh.
What a good mindless minion.
I'm known for my excellent timing. No, I am not making this up as I go.
Even if I activate Field of Ruin here, it's not like really... I mean, I only have two mana. It's not like there's anything like really great I can hit anyway. So I'm going to wait on the Field of Ruin activation for after this, because like if there's like two more lands on top, then I'm going to need to Field of Ruin away.
I'll protect you.
I mean, unfortunately, we know we're drawing this forest.
Remorse,
the card that we need to look for, like, that's going to be our ninth land drop, so Fight with Fire. We got three of them in the deck. Fight with Fire can clear up a bunch of these things. Could kill Liliana and Teferi, for example. Yeah, I could just field them during their turn to not draw this forest. Thing is, I don't really mind drawing that forest still, because like I said, I want 9 mana for, like, I need Fight with Fire and 9 mana, so I do need that 9th land. Yeah, I'll just wait for whenever we have Frenzy in play. It's just much more effective for when you actually have Frenzy in play. But of course, actually untapping with Frenzy and having a good amount of mana, that is, of course. Not like having Frenzy in play and then right now, because I don't have like the mana to do anything anyway. Yeah, we could have sacked Brontodon at instant speed, yes, but also the Brontodon's not doing anything against these Liliana tokens, and I wanted to see if we could start playing stuff with Frenzy. No, I won't, Leo. I don't play Modern anymore.
Trust me.
Hey, Chief Seth.
Hold that thought.
putrid, but effective.
Well, we're up a game, so even though this one doesn't look great, there we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So I can kill Liliana. Do I want to kill Teferi Time Raveler? It's 8 and then 2 over here for 9-10. Five, three, two.
Time for plan. I really should have seen that coming.
Death won't conquer me so easily.
All right, that's a start. The old Thought Erasure against the Frenzy in play. It's the 2-mana Surveil 1. Well, good timing on that Surveil 1. I got rid of a land. No.
Time is much more malleable than people think.
All right, down to 8. And the Paradise Druid gets to get rid of one of these things. We're 2 cards away from that Frenzy again. Wouldn't mind drawing Chandra next turn. Chandra took up play Frenzy also. Or just drawing another Fight with Fire. That'd be nice too.
Let's skip to the
I'm not gonna upkeep Field of Ruin. I want this Frenzy back. I don't want to shuffle my Frenzy away. Alright, Phoenix is cool. Car can do something. Maybe.
No time for a break.
We have a lot of cards over there. I've been drawing multiple cards a turn here for a while. A lot of cards. I'm hoping they're just sitting on like lands and Kaya's Wraths. Already played 2 Kaya's Wraths though, and Thought Erasures. That's all I want them to have. Kaya's Wraths, Thought Erasure. All right, that's fine. At least we're not in imminent danger of dying now. And this is where we Field of Ruin. Now we have a lot of mana. Ugh, still a land. Where's my Sword Tooths? Have we seen any Sortusas? Yeah, we've seen two. Okay.
Hurry.
So all the Hellkites are gone. Yeah, Chandra would come in handy for sure. We have all four Chandras still. Sortooth. Land. Yeah, another frenzy. All right, good turn, good turn. So they get to draw two cards a turn with Teferi. We get that, though. We do have to worry about the Othakaya killing us, of course. Need to make sure that we don't die to that thing. But we just went from 33 cards in library last turn to 27 now. So good turn. Now, a lot of players have kind of moved away from Mortify. A lot of Esper players. We haven't seen any Mortifies yet. All right, we could use another fight with fire to kill this Teferi, because I don't really want to attack it. It's at 5 loyalty right now. We have 2 fight with fires left. No, I don't have Twister in the deck. I'm pretty sure. Omri.
Let's see some panic in the streets. We won't answer to other guilds.
All right, well, a pretty poor turn, but that turn still got rid of 4 cards. We're just closer to finding our fight with fire.
Hurry!
Pretty sure there's 2 fight with fires left. Pretty sure I have 3 in the deck right now. I haven't seen a Chandra at all. There's 4 of them in here. We may run out of cards. We may mill ourselves. Oh, dang. We're down to 1. Well, I can't attack a Teferi at all now. I'm glad they just did that Othakaya right now and not let me know that I can't attack Teferi. Because, you know, if they just let me attack Teferi once and then, you know, just hold that Othakaya... Maybe I accidentally kill myself.
Hey, over here.
No, don't tap the Field of Ruin. Let's clear that Chandra off this way. Do I just want to blow up Othakaya and then attack Teferi for 3? Or do I want to start attacking them? I'm at 16 cards in library. By Field of Ruin, I'll have 3 mana left. Not a whole lot to do with 3 mana. I'll just keep it and draw this forest here.
Let's skip to the good part.
Why should I cast the second Chandra? Just to tick up and get rid of this forest? But I'll just draw the forest. Instead of having like Fight with Fire as like the very next card, where then we'd have to draw it, you know, like this is a bad card to draw and we want bad cards. We want to draw a bad card.
This might be a bad idea.
They gotta have an instant speed wrath then, right? All right, I think I'm gonna blow up one of these frenzies. Something we can use this mana for. They've already played 3 Kaya's Wraths and 2 Cry of the Carnariums. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Alright, so that's their 4th Kaya's Wrath. Are you kidding me? Kidding me. That was not something that was unexpected right there. So I only have 3 lands left, 4 lands left in the deck. I'm not gonna take this land out. I'm gonna leave it there. It's like something that maybe we mill over. No, there's a fight with fire.
This is just gonna be bad for you.
All of our Chandras are like at the very bottom of our library. I think there's still another fight with fire in these last 5 cards. Probably gonna need all 5 of these draw steps though. I'm certainly worried about killing my opponent if I draw the land. Or if I'd play the land. I have to do 32 before I deck out. That Enter the God Eternals was really clutch. I wish I would have just cast Fight with Fire that first main phase. I was trying to envision something they could have like that was going to really punish me for that. I didn't think of Enter the God Eternals.
Keep up the pace.
Been really nice to play that first main.
more like it.
Four cards left. Well, that's the last land in the deck.
There's no problem fire can't solve.
So 8 puts them down to 24. Stop. This is the Silver Sun pickups. Yeah, there's Teferi Ultimate. As long as they can't draw a card, if they just Teferi Ultimate but can't actually draw a card, we'd be fine. Yeah, that's what I was hoping, that like just attacks Chandra minus 7 and fight with fire. Like, you know, that's another 17 damage here. No, that's 17 plus 11, you know, so that's what? 28. So now I can't kill my opponent now with that fight with that Moment of Craving they just had.
I'm gonna have to
wait another turn. I can't just Chandra minus 7 now. It doesn't lose the game. Just exiles the top cards of your library. It doesn't draw a card.
You won.
Am I dematerializing?
That Moment of Craving.
Here we go.
And, you know, now this Kaya is kind of putting it out of reach now. Also.
What's that smell? Jeez. Oh, it's you burning.
I have to do this. Because this Teferi bounce. That Teferi gets rid of both of these. After Teferi ult. So I need to do one damage to this thing.
No more game.
Because, like, if they Teferi ult, and then they have big Teferi ultimates, and then the little Teferi bounces one creature, then they get the trigger for draw a card, and then get to exile the other, so it gets rid of both of my creatures.
You beat me this time. Bravo.
No, there's no reason to play that Frenzy. I have one card in my library.
need to move quickly.
Yeah, you just popped in. Yeah. Yeah, we only have one card left. I thought I had this a couple of times, that Enter the God Eternals and then the Moment of Craving. Let's see what our opponent has left for some defense.
Right on schedule.
Well, that's good.
Let's try this.
I'm glad they didn't ultimate their other Teferi. Of course, they probably just drew this stuff off of that other draw. So I don't think I can. I don't think I have anything here. Because I think I'm going to be 1 point short. Because this should be set minus 7 for Chandra, and then 5 for Phoenix. That's 12. Oh, now that makes that even less. Yeah, this is game 2. So close. Alright, so definitely learned that I want this extra fight with fire. Getting one of those milled cost me that. Brontodon was awesome too, with them having Ixalan's bindings. And I don't think I need the Domri. I don't need that extra mana there. And then I'll cut an Incubation Druid. And I think I won all these other cards. Maybe just 3 Brontodon. Paradise Druid. We have seen them have a whole lot of sweepers. You know, they played all 4 of the Kai's Wrath that last game and everything. That was a pretty good game, though. We fought through a ton. Almost got there. So much life gain. Between all those Oath of Kaia's and Moment of Cravings and Enter the God Eternals and all that kind of stuff, there's so much life gain. Go, Bronte, go. Definitely need to find a Chandra or a Frenzy. You know, like, we need, like, those are our 2 engine cards. Really want to draw those cards. Like, that's what I want to be drawing. Chandra or Frenzy. All 4 of our Chandras too were in like the bottom 15 cards of our library or something like that. Bottom 18. Something like that. The last game. That hurt. So Phoenix is nice here because it doesn't just die to Akai's Wrath also. If you know, so we get to put something else on the battlefield but not be that worried about Kaia's Wrath. But yeah, really want to draw Chandra or Frenzy. Do they have 1 mana kill something? They think that Mox Amber was going to let them cast a Moment of Craving. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What if they don't have... What if they don't have a basic island? Is that possible? Last game, we only saw a basic swamp. Well... Yeah, that was the only basic we saw last game. Let's see. Seven... All right, so now they got no blue mana for now. Yeah, Oath has a picture of Kaya in it. Yeah, see, this is a Kaya. All right, have to shock for Thought Erasure. All right, now this is where we draw Frenzy, and then get two land drops, and then our Swordtooth is active. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Ten. Suffer gets it in. So this should be that moment of craving. Yeah, that they thought they were going to be able to play with after the with the Mox Amber. So Kaya's Wrath doesn't save him because of Phoenix. If they would play a legend here, you know, like some legendary creature, I would in response blow up the Mox Amber. If they, I mean, like a Planeswalker, sorry, not legendary creature, but if they would have played a Planeswalker there. All right, well, good match there. And Gruul Frenzy is now 2-1. I had a Nugan out and a Mox Amber that made no mana. Yeah, it's got to be a color. Whenever Mox Amber and Karn, Scion of Urza were in that same set in Dominaria, we were all thinking, oh, wow, Karn and Mox Amber work so well together because Karn minuses and makes these artifact creatures. We can have these Mox Ambers. And then we're, then ever, like, that's like the first thought. And then it, then you realize, wait a minute. Mox Amber doesn't add any mana if you just have a Karn in play. Gotta have some other legend. It's not good enough. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. All right, we're not going to be able to turn on the Swordtooth this turn, so I think I'm just going to play. I think I'm just going to go land Chandra so that my Land War Elf can attack the Narset for one. And have the Chandra in play first before we play the Frenzy, because obviously if we play the Frenzy first, then we can't play the Chandra. Field of Ruin's not too common, but it's a little common. I don't think you necessarily need to play like four basics in a three-color deck. I think you do need at least two basics, though. I think that's like the minimum. Like, I would recommend having at the very least two basics in these kind of decks. That's what, our second Esper in a row, I think. Yeah, this is just our second Esper opponent in a row, so it's not like it's nothing but Esper. Just two in a row. Alright, want to hit a land here.
Let's light it up.
Nope.
You cannot see.
Because, you know, we can play the other land with, because of Swordtooth, so if it was another land, we could have played it. Oh, yeah, that the Bant ramp with Nissa, Finale of Glory, and Krasis, that's probably the hottest deck right now.
It's maybe the
best deck. So, yeah, if you're saying, should I try that deck? Yeah, it's good. That's the deck that now the rest of the metagame is going to have to start adapting to that deck. No! Don't take my Frenzy. No. Coil. But look at how coiled in lava this person is. You don't want that to be you.
Sit back and watch it burn.
Do I want to blow up this black source here? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. I kind of want a Field of Ruin and then play Phoenix. But then if they just have another Swamp and then like Moment of Craving, my land wore off, then I don't actually turn on the Swordtooth, and then that's sad. So I guess I'll just miss out on 1 point of damage. No, not upkeep. Some people don't play swamps. Most people do, but maybe this person doesn't. Wow, just no basics? Wow. Field of Ruin. OP. We should have 4 Field of Ruins in here. I don't know numbers. I don't know the answer to your question. What's the Esper and Grixis matchup for Bant ramp like? I don't know. I haven't played Bant ramp myself. It's possible that our opponent has 2 basics in their deck and they're both in their hand, right? Like, that's possible that just, like, they've drawn both the basics or, you know, they have 1 basic and it's in their hand or, you know, something like that.
Don't worry. I got this.
No problem, fire can't solve.
We will meet again.
Sure, we will. Maybe next game. So all we need to do is Chandra -7 and Phoenix for 4. That would be 11. So I want Fight, Chandra, Labrontodon, Cut, Coil, Domri. Cut 1 Brontodon. Cut the Incubation Druid. All right. Let's try again. Yeah, maybe we should be playing 4 Field of Ruin main deck. Especially with Paradise Druid being able to just add red, even if we don't have the red source, where Incubation Druid before couldn't add red unless you had the red source. Because Field of Ruin does work really well when you have the Frenzy to shuffle. I literally cannot play Magic without making the most greedy of mistakes. I know that life. I'd be down for Sinkhole in Standard. I like casting some Sinkholes. Can you imagine, like, turn 2 Sinkhole, turn 3 Sinkhole, turn 4 Mission Briefing Sinkhole? Let's just play all these things they know about. We got 4 power out here. We played against Phoenix our first round with this deck. I have not played Golgari Land Destruction. No, I haven't. Counter's a good draw.
You want to play with fire, huh? Sit back and watch it burn.
Kill that. Alright, that was a good turn. No, Brontodon.
Let's light it up.
Let's light it up. I probably should have Field of Ruined one of these Godless Shrines. Or like the Godless Shrine there. But just the auto tap tapped it.
All right, that's it.
Need more cards.
This is just going to be bad for you.
So they did have that basic. So we've seen a basic planes. Well, I mean, sure, I could make it a 4-4 haste. It would get cast downed anyway. I guess the previous turn, maybe I could have dealt some damage.
Nobody tells me what to do. What's that smell? Oh, it's you burning.
All right, we're one permanent away from turning on the sword tooth. Not exactly sure why our opponent wrathed there. Yeah, it could be. Yeah, maybe command the Dreadhorde. That's a good call. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Yeah, that's what it looks like. All right, I forgot about command the Dreadhorde being a card. I just forgot about that being a card. I should have been more aggressive with my creatures. With my mana creatures in particular, like attacking more. Yeah, I forgot about command the Dreadhorde. That's what it looks like with how our opponent's looking through all the graveyards, so. Going down to one, get those. Gain six again, back up to seven.
We're done here.
If I haste, I put them down to one. But how am I getting the last point of damage in? I don't know. I guess we'll figure that out later. I'm two mana away from casting a Kicked Fight with Fire, which is like the only spell that I have that deals direct damage. Want to find a frenzy. All right, Phoenix is good. Phoenix works. Turns on the sword tooth. And I think we just trade these while I can. I think that's just a good trade. Especially having this Phoenix. Like, where if they find a cast down, you know, that kills the Hellkite, then they can block my Phoenix. But now a cast down, I guess it'd be the same thing, really. But we turned on the Ascend before that, so that's good. Yeah, can't shoot it with the dragon. The dragon can only do the ability if it has a counter on it, and it was just a 4-4, so it did not have a counter on it. Alright, let's see if they brick. Those are three really good draws for us in a row. Hellkite, Phoenix. Well, they'll use the Teferi to bounce the token. That means they only got 4 mana left to find something else. Yulin, good evening. This has been a fun league. Been a lot of pretty fun matches here. Hey, Ludacris. No. Don't do it. Don't do it. If they had another white source, good thing we field a rune to white source earlier. No white mana. All right, 3-1. There's no sound bug right now, right? Just want to make sure. We just gotta reward people. We were talking about the sound bug yesterday before I click play another match, just in case I need to reset it. Doesn't seem like anybody say anything about a sound bug. Okay. Good. No sound bug. I don't know what it is. I've never heard it. But maybe it's a little easier to hear on the YouTube video where there's not the music though also. No. Not the red deck. No, not the red deck. Please don't chain whirler my stuff. I'd really appreciate no chain whirler. Ow. Want to save coil for if there is a chain whirler. Want to coil the chain whirler. All right, good. No chain whirler. I think I am just gonna block here though. Let the Paradise Druid do something before it gets chain whirled away. Or lightning stricken away. Alright, so we know they don't have Chain Whirler, right? Like, pretty sure at least. Let's get rid of the Lava Runner, because that thing would be a 2-2. Instead of the 2-1. We need to draw lands. Cool, Matt. Yeah, glad you're liking this deck. Not the bestest of lands. Thank you.
to see you. Busting heads is my bread and butter.
Phoenix requires 2 red mana. If I had 2 red mana, I would have been playing the Phoenix. Sweet.
Hear me again.
Oh, alright, that's fine. Blah. This is our loss earlier, was mono red. And one thing that's kind of been the story of these losses to mono red is I've been just stuck on lands. The previous 2 games that we lost to mono red, I didn't hit a 4th land drop right away either. And that's what's kind of been going on here. Why would they not just do that light up the stage first? I could have light up the stage and hit like a chain whirler and killed me. Oh well. They thought I wouldn't block. Yep, I'm at 7. I definitely just don't want to block with these crappy 1/1s. Alright, let's bring in all this stuff. Can I just take out these mana creatures completely? Like, is that possible? Hey, Jem. Thanks for the bits there. Things are just so bad later on in the game and against Chain Whirler and everything. This curve is terrible, of course, but I wonder if we can get away with this. All right, can't take out Land Werewolf. Because, like, the other thing about taking those things out is then I have, like, the cannonades. Which, you know, like, cannonade doesn't work too well with these things anyway. I'm gonna try it. Hey, we got some lands. Perfect. The most important thing of this plan, of course, is to actually draw the lands. So Fight with Fire and Lava Coil, both, there's like reasons to play one or, you know, to play the other. A Chandra next turn. This, you know, we get to kick later on. This could get rid of a Phoenix later on.
problem fire can't solve. When people start screaming, like, what's that smell? Oh!
No, I've never seen the movie Hocus Pocus. So two Chandras just go back and forth, right?
Let's light it up.
I think my best plan is just being aggressive here. I think we can outrace them.
Sit back and watch it burn.
Obviously, I could be wrong about that, but I think that's my plan here. Yeah, I didn't coil plus Brontodon, because I'm just going to go Hellkite. Maybe my plan was flawed. I mean, it's starting to look flawed. It's not really looking like we're winning the race now. Alright, so I want to make sure that I don't die my next turn, because with Chandra doing the whole minus seven thing, and then Hellkite's attacking for eight. May they just have 7 points of burn? I hope not. Wow. All right. Well, I guess I need to Brontodon coil the previous turn. That was a lot of burn spells that they had. Oh, here, let's go collect our prizes. There. So 3-2 with Gruul Frenzy. We did lose both of our matches to Mono Red. Looks like maybe I could have won that. Or I don't even know if I would have won that, but I could have put myself in a better position, I guess, by going Coil Brontodon the turn before. But yeah, Mono Red's tough. There's not a lot of real good life gain in these colors, but maybe that's what, maybe, I mean, I just don't have life gain in here basically at all. By basically at all, I mean at all. Maybe that's what I need more than, you know, Brontodon, Twister. You have like Twister, Ripjaw for that matchup. As you can tell, we weren't really playing Twisters or Ripjaws, but that's what I have for Mono Red. Maybe I need some life gain instead of Twister, Ripjaw. Somewhere there. Yeah, Spellbreaker's good against Chandra. It's true. Maybe Spellbreaker's better than Living Twister. I think maybe I could just use some more early removal. Like, maybe instead of Living Twisters, maybe just have, like, more Shivan Fires. Like, where if I do just go with the cut the mana creatures plan, maybe get like another Fiery Cannonade and Shivan Fires and stuff, and then not have just all three drops kind of thing. Yeah, I think I probably need to maybe reimagine that matchup. I was thinking that these big creatures would be pretty good there, but I don't think that that's really good enough. I think maybe just a lot more early removal and fiery cannonades kind of thing. Maybe not. I'm not sure. I'm going to have to work on that matchup a little bit. No, Fountain Renewal isn't. That's not a playable card. That's way too slow. It would have to be something else. Not exactly sure what, but there are some different options for creatures that gain life. Deathgorge Scavenger isn't really not that good. Like, it's just too, like, the two life and only trading with get two Lava Runners, like trading with Shock for a three drop. That's just not impactful enough. There's like Corral Foragers. Honestly, maybe it's like just Bond to Flourishing kind of thing as like something to do on turn two that kind of helps you out still, helps you hit your land drops or go find Frenzy, Chandra, your Phoenix, Hellkite, or whatever. But I think I could probably use some more removal in general for that matchup. So I think that's like where it starts, more 1 and 2 mana removal. But I don't want to change the deck up for like the other matchups. The mana creatures are really vital. Definitely, I don't want to play the Explore package in here. That just takes up too many slots. Hey, red deck wins splashing green solely for Swordtooth. No, I don't think I want to do that. I think the mana creatures are worth it. They're really good in other matchups. But just got to work on the red deck wins matchup. All the other matchups felt good, you know, like we were 3-0 against other decks, but just need to work on that deck, on that matchup. Possible I need to move towards Incubation Druid instead of Paradise Druid. That's a possibility. As we talked about, like Druid of the Cowl. There's other things to do. I could maybe instead of like just honestly, probably the first thing to do. Because how we were talking about like how the 3-mana slot I just have, I had too many 3s. So I think just playing Thorn Lieutenant instead of Living Twister. Whoops, I want that Chandra. I think I want a third Shivan Fire and then Thorn Lieutenant instead of Living Twister. So that we get to still have, so we can have like the 2-drop. I think that's a good place to start there. Get another Shivan Fire and Thorn Lieutenants. I think that works. There. And then we're not just all jumbled up on the 3-mana slot. That could be a good upgrades. Alright. So there we go. That's Gruul Frenzy. Had a good time with the deck. We'll continue to work on it. Play it again sometime soon. So if you're watching this video later on YouTube, I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you so much for watching Gruul Frenzy here. And I hope to see you for another video.